I came home late that night, much later than I should have. We had a new case that was taking up most of my time. I promised my wife I wouldn't bring my work home, but now she was gone, and work was the only thing I had left in here. We had two unsolved murders on our table, two dead girls, found in the same week. That was my case. I wanted to go over the information we had, just to be sure I didn't miss anything. There it was. Three things the both cases had in common. Thank you.
morning, Detective.
What do we have here, Sergeant?
I think you should talk to Detective Garner, sir.
Alex is already here?
Yes, sir. They're all here.
So what do we have?
It looks like another one, but I don't know. Take a look.
Yeah, it's exactly the same as the other two victims.
Third victim with the same MO. Shit. I'm gonna call the LT and tell him we've got a serial here. You see what else you can find out about her.
Something is missing here. There is no blood.
What do you mean?
There is no blood. She's got her body cut open, but there's no blood anywhere.
You're right. That means we've got a secondary crime scene. I'm gonna call patrol and have them search the nearby area, see if they can find the primary scene. You take a look around, see what else you can find around here.
Any witnesses?
Nothing so far.
Who found the body?
Construction workers. When they came in from their morning shift at 6 o'clock, they didn't see anyone either.
Oh, hey, James.
Morning, Michael. Think you'll be able to get anything out of this mess?
No, not a chance. Security console's fried, the drives are wiped out. If there was any security footage, it's gone now. So what do you think happened here?
This wasn't just some random act of violence. Whoever did this knew exactly what he was doing and why. He disabled the cameras, wiped out security records, destroyed security feed, and left. Nothing else. He did it only to destroy the evidence. But he didn't come here with a plan. He just needed to get rid of her body, so he grabbed the first thing he saw and used it. The whole scene was just an improvisation. The location, chains, the body pose, none of that matters. He did it only to mess with us. Only important thing here is the girl, who she was, and why she was killed.
We need to find a way the suspect got in and out. If the girl wasn't killed here, someone had to drag the body in somehow.
This leads to the main control room. It's used only by the subway personnel, and it's locked all the time. Plus, all the security cameras in that area still work.
Where does this lead?
This is a service tunnel that's being used by the construction workers. It leads to a service parking space. It's supposed to be locked, but I think the construction guys keep it open overnight.
It's been 3 days since you were killed. Probably even more since you went missing. And we still don't know anything about you. No name, no address, nothing. She's not in here. Why are you dead and no one is looking for you? She was young. Someone had to miss her. She was good looking, attractive, athletic type. Hard to believe no one would notice she disappeared. She went jogging before she died. Means she had to live somewhere. You were a young, attractive girl. So why do we have no idea who you are?
I look so calm like that, don't you think? You are so close. And yet, you still have no idea who I really was.
She wasn't from here. She wasn't local. That's why she's not in any missing persons reports. Because no one from here is looking for her. She might be from another state. Maybe even a different country. We were looking for her at the wrong places.
I was messed up, girl. Miserable. Broken. But I look peaceful here. Almost happy. Maybe I deserved what happened. Maybe it's better this way. It's not like you could have changed it anyway.
She was a tourist.
finally. So can we start now?
You really took your sweet time, James.
So, what do we have?
James was right. They were tourists. We extended the search and contacted Interpol, and we finally found a match. Our last victim was Emily Patterson, 24-year-old student from London, UK. She arrived at Boston Airport 15 days ago. One of the previous victims was Marie Slovakova from Czech Republic. Student, 22. Arrived in the country 12 days ago. We are still checking older records for the first girl. We were able to track their movement from their credit card records and their student IDs.
Anything unusual about what they were doing in the States?
They were both in Portland.
Yeah, that might be a coincidence, though.
No, don't think so. Both victims at the same place at the same time? That's too much of a coincidence. Besides, we have no other leads right now.
All right, find the third girl, our first victim. That should be our priority now. And call Portland PD to see if we could figure out what they were doing in there. That's it for now.
Thank you.
came home late that night, much later than I should have, just as I did 1,000 times before. I promised my wife it wouldn't happen anymore, just as I did 1,000 times before. I came home late that night, much later than I should have, just as I did 1,000 times before. But this time, something was wrong. Do we have anything on the owner?
Not yet. It's going to be a few more hours before we get the records from the county.
Lock is busted open, and this is a solid steel door. Not easy to break. Someone really wanted to get inside. This is how the killer got in. found a few order receipts. Apparently, this building belongs to some import-export company. Orders are written to a name, Thomas Kaufman. Why would he break a door into his own warehouse and kill a girl in it? This was something else. Someone might be trying to frame him. Stage a victim in his house for a police to find?
I'm going to run a background check on him anyway, just in case.
Looks the same. Young girl, same characteristics, same injuries. But something is different here. There is blood this time. A lot. Looks like the victim was killed right here. I've got something over here.
What is it?
Not sure, but my guess? Probably cocaine.
Are you sure? Damn it. If there are drugs involved, we're gonna have to notify the DEA. This case is just getting worse by the minute.
We need to run this for fingerprints. Might get something useful. There is something down there. Black body bag. It's still full of blood. The victim wasn't killed here at all. She was dead long before she got here. She wasn't killed here, so why the blood? He tried to make it look like he killed her here. Why? Someone is watching.
What do you want?
I'm a police officer. I'm investigating a murder that happened right across the street.
Murder?
Yes, sir. I would like to ask you a few questions.
Mm-hmm.
Did you see what happened there last night?
You guys came here in the middle of the night. They broke into the old warehouse. One of them picked up something from the car and dragged it upstairs.
They had a car?
Mm-hmm. I don't know what it was, though. It looked like a big car, an SUV or something. Some dark color. I couldn't really see it very well. It was dark outside. I didn't see anything else.
Thank you. Thank you.
I came home late that night, but it didn't matter. There was no one else waiting for me. No one who would care. Someone was just using them to smuggle drugs out of the country. They were couriers, pack mules.
Gentlemen, this is Agent Sawyer from DEA. So sit down and listen to what he has to say.
Your detective was right about your victims. They were probably couriers, drug mules. Every one of them had traces of diphenhydramine in their system.
So what? They were smuggling drugs to Europe? Is it even worth it?
Normally, it's not. But there is one thing that is very unusual about this. The drug you found on the crime scene was cocaine, with almost 98% purity. That's the highest purity we've ever seen. And with product this pure, that's something else. There is no way to get product of this quality anywhere in Europe. And some people in certain circles are willing to pay big money for something like that. It's a status thing more than anything else. You could sell 1 pound of this on the street in New York for 10 grand, or sell it in certain parts of London for 200,000.
Holy shit.
Exactly.
And why are they using the young girls for this?
It's a perfect cover, really. It's a one-time deal. These girls are clean, they have no connection to the drug trade, so they buy them a ticket, pay for a nice vacation, use them to take drugs back to Europe, and still make 150 grand on them.
Do we know who is behind this?
The illegal drug market in the Northwest is controlled by two major groups. The first one is led by a man called Santiago. As far as we know, he came from South America 10 years ago and overtook most of the drug market in this area. He's a really unstable man. His organization is controlled by brutality and fear. Although he owns almost 80% of the market, he deals mostly in low-grade and low-quality drugs. But in the last few years, a new name started to show up. Thomas Kaufman.
Kaufman? The owner of the warehouse where we found our last victim?
Yes. He hides his illegal drug business behind a legal import-export company. Unlike Santiago, Kaufman is actually intelligent. He's not selling drugs on the streets, and instead, he's focusing on higher-class clients and more expansive drugs. They have the market divided between themselves, with Santiago selling the quantity and Kaufman selling the quality. That's why they managed to stay out of each other's throats, until now.
So, if someone was using European students to smuggle high-quality drugs out of the country, it would be Kaufman.
Yes.
And if someone learned about this, someone with violent tendencies, he might want to send a message and kill the girls before they leave the country.
Exactly.
So, what is going to happen now?
We want you to continue your investigation.
That is not what I expected.
We've been trying to get them for years now. And we've been close, trust me. But it never worked. This time, it's different. They made a mistake. And we can get them for good. That's why we don't want to interfere until we have to. We feel like more DEA agents might alert them. You continue your investigation. If we can get them convicted based on your evidence, then they have no chance.
Yeah, right. Won't interfere until they have to take all the credit for our work.
Shut up, Carlos. You hurt the man. Now get back to work.
Thank you.
Got any witnesses?
Nothing so far.
What happened here?
An anonymous called 911 about a man dragging something that looked like a dead body. He claimed the suspect was still in the building, so we set a perimeter and we called the SWAT team. But they've swept the place clean and there's nobody here. Probably left before we even got here.
So you were first on the scene?
Well, not exactly. We secured the crime scene, but Detective Oritz was already here.
Carlos was here before you?
Yes, sir.
Victim was killed only a few hours ago. We need to set up a timeline, figure out when she got here and when she left. Killer didn't have much time to do this.
Do we have phone records for this?
We do. There was only 3 calls to this number today. 2 were routine calls, but the last one was a prepaid phone. Untraceable.
Just an hour before she died. Her laptop is still here, but I don't see her phone anywhere. Gotcha.
Thank you. Hey, just got back the info from the county. Guess who's the owner of this apartment complex? Thomas Kaufman. I just called George. He thinks we've got enough evidence now to get a search warrant. He wants us back at the station in an hour.
I just got off the phone with the judge. We got our ticket in. We got a search warrant. For Santiago, Kaufman, all their private estates, and all their company premises. This is what we've been waiting for. No one else has got so close to them. We have a chance to take them out, but we have to work fast. We could wait a few more days until we get information about our last victim, but by that time it might be too late. With every hour we wait, there is a chance that Santiago or Kaufman will learn about this. And if they do, then everything we've worked for will be gone. We can finish this, but we have to be swift, and we need to decide now. James, I know this is officially still your case, so the decision is up to you.
Let's do it. You are right. We can't lose any more time. We need to take them out. Now.
Alex, I need you to coordinate with the tactical team. Carlos, you keep an eye on our DEA friend. I want to make sure he doesn't fuck up anything. What is it, James? You look like you're still not sure about this.
I don't know. It doesn't feel right. There are still some things that don't make sense. And we don't have any solid evidence that would connect the victims to Kaufman or Santiago.
There has to be a link somewhere, right? What about our last victim? Did you ever check her planner?
Planner? There was no planner on the crime scene.
What? Oh, well, I just assumed, you know, since she was a student, she'd keep everything in her planner and all. Never mind, then.
Don't worry about it, James. You did an exceptional job on this case. Thanks to you, the world will be a better place tomorrow. Now get to work. We have a big night ahead of us.
I knew we had to do it. I knew they were involved somehow, and removing the two biggest drug lords from the streets would be best for everyone. But something didn't feel right. I had a few hours before the arrest, and I had one more thing I needed to check. Address from victim's apartment. Could be nothing. Could be the reason she was dead. The address led me to an abandoned warehouse in the middle of nowhere. I had a feeling I was on the right track, but I was afraid of what I might find on the end of it. fucking hell.
To be a link somewhere, right? What about our last victim? Did you ever check her planner?
Planner? There was no planner on the crime scene. The planner. Was this just a coincidence? Or did he know about her planner? Is Carlos somehow involved in this? I left that place as fast as I could. I didn't call anyone. I didn't tell anyone what I found in there. I had to be sure. Was it just a coincidence? Or is Carlos somehow involved in this? And if he is, how can I trust anyone else? Carlos Ortiz. He was promoted to detective only a few years ago, and I can't say I know him that well. He's intelligent, competent, but rough. Not exactly a friendly guy. The worst part is, it wouldn't surprise me if he was actually involved in this. Michael Keegan. He's the youngest detective in our department. Extremely talented, with great technical skills, and really friendly kid. I would never consider him to be a killer. Alex. I've known him for almost 20 years. We joined around the same time, and we've been working together for so long. If there is anyone I trust in this department, it's him. His physical appearance fits the suspect. Same height. About the same age. Carlos owns a black SUV. Witnesses saw the same car at the crime scene. Somehow, he knew the victim had a planner. He was the first one at the last crime scene, before anyone else, even before the responding officers. Sooner than he ever could be, unless he was already there.
Should have just let it go, James.
You were always a bad shot, Alex.
Shut up, James. Don't make this any harder for me.
Oh, really? Should I make this easier for you somehow? Why don't I just shoot myself then? Would that make you feel any better after what you've done?
You have no idea what you are talking about.
No? Then tell me. We both know how this is going to end, so you can at least tell me why the fuck you're doing this. Is it just about money? Did Kaufman give you an offer you couldn't refuse? Or Santiago? Or what the hell happened?
This has nothing to do with Kaufman or Santiago. They had no idea what was happening. They didn't even know the girls were dead.
What? Then who the fuck are you working for?
man with a vision.
What the hell are you doing, Alex? We don't have time for this.
Just finish him so we can get out of here. We need to be in the docks in 40 minutes.
I thought you had something to do with this, Carlos. But why you, Michael?
What do you think? Money. When we get out of here, I'll never have to move a finger again.
What makes you think you can get away with this? What about Kaufman and Santiago? You will never be able to convict them. They will never confess to something they haven't done.
You're right. They won't. And they don't have to. Because they are dead.
What?
The arrest already happened, James. A few hours ago. Santiago was mental, high out of his mind. When the police showed up, he just started shooting. They had no choice but to take him down.
You fucks. You planned on that, didn't you? What about Kaufman? He wasn't that stupid. He would never just start shooting and get himself killed.
You're right. They arrested him and sent him to a detention. And you know how it goes. Security camera broke, and before you know it, Kaufman was found dead in his cell. Hanged himself. What a tragic accident, huh?
You never wanted to get them arrested. You just needed to get rid of them.
Yes, exactly. And thanks to you, there will be enough evidence pointing against them that no one will question what really happened.
And even if there wasn't, they were still criminals. Santiago was a brutal, crazy drug baron. He didn't kill those girls, but he killed others. And Kaufman did use those girls to smuggle drugs, and he knew we can prove it. Nobody is going to miss them.
And who do you think you are working for? Whoever it is, he's just another maniac, hungry for power. You'll switch one drug lord for another, and nothing is going to change.
You have no idea how wrong you are right now, James. You don't know what you got yourself into. This is so much bigger than you, bigger than us, Kaufman or Santiago. The man who hired us is so much more than just some pathetic drug lord. He doesn't care what happens here. He doesn't care about the Northwest. He wants to control the whole country. And he will. Things like this, arrests, deals, revolts, and killings are happening all over the states right now. What the police were trying to achieve for decades, he will do overnight. Tomorrow, over 70 drug lords and cartel leaders will be in jail or dead, and over 500,000 people will be without a job, without a plan. Whole drug businesses will be in chaos and disarray. All ready for him to take over. He already has people in the right places working for him. So when he steps out of the shadows, everything will be his. All the drug trade in the United States controlled by a single man. Just like that. There will be a whole new world tomorrow.
And you want to be a part of this? Did he really give you so much money that you lost your fucking mind? Enough money to kill four young girls?
What? No, no, we didn't kill them. We're not murderers, James. We just got their bodies, arranged them, set up the clues for you to find, and let you do the rest.
So he just used you to get rid of Kaufman and Santiago.
And we used you to not get busted for it. That's how it goes, James.
Why? Why did you even let that investigation happen? Why did you need all this bullshit show?
You still don't get it, do you? We needed the investigation. And we needed you to lead it. You're our scapegoat, James. There is always a chance that something will go wrong. Someone will start asking questions. And they will be looking for someone to blame. And they will find your name on the paper.
You were there too. You were part of the investigation as well.
True, we were. But it was you who connected the non-existent dots. It was your investigation, your name on the arrest warrant that started all of this. It was you who took out the two biggest drug lords in the Northwest, and no one would be surprised if they found you dead. Revenge from the drug cartels.
Except I'm still here.
Yeah, that is a small complication. We never wanted to kill you. At least I didn't, not at first. We needed you to instigate the arrest, and you did just that. But you didn't stop there. I wasn't expecting that. I was hoping you'd just let it go and accept the case we orchestrated for you, but you didn't. And when you got too close, we had to get rid of you. I'm not going to compromise what we've done here. I'm not going to jail because of you, James.
What the
hell was
that?
Check it out.
You hear that? You fucked it up, Alex.
What is
you fucked it up. You should have killed me when you had the chance.
Call him right now.
Now they're coming for me.
Shut the fuck up, James.
And they're going to take you out as well.
Go see if you can stall them.
Listen, I know we fucked up.
You hear me, you fuck?
No, you don't understand.
You are going to die here, just like me.
Please, we can fix this, just...
It's too late for that, Alex.
Shut up.
We have him right here, just call them off.
They don't give a shit about you.
Shut up, James.
You're just a fucking liability.
The fuck are we gonna do?
Just fucking kill him.
Screw you.
I just thought I'd let you know that Alex, Michael, and Carlos are dead. And so are the people you sent after them. And now, I'm coming for you.